We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and over the last 8 weeks we've been hitting every new product on the market, and we now feel that we're in a position where we can tell you about our best mid-handicap irons of 2021. Let's get started by having a look at how we categorise this group of irons. Okay, we break all of our iron categories down from 1 to 5. So basically we've got a blade on number 1 and a hybrid iron over on number 5, and everything else fits in between that. Just tell us a bit more about the idea, Neil.
Yeah, so as you can see there, so category 1 being your blade, we've got a little bit of a rough guide there as well, so I'm in a handicap guide. And guys, it is a rough guide. I know there's a lot of guys out there that are better ball strikers than the handicap suggests because of short game issues or whatever, but it's only a rough guide, but we feel we've got it quite accurate, Simon. So you can see, like Simon's just touched upon there, category 1 being your muscle back blade, sorry. Handicap would be 4 and below, I would say. Generally, you get your better ball strikers into that sort of category. Your player's iron, handicap 8 and below, again, only a rough guide. Your player's distance iron, 12 below. Mid-handicap iron would be 10 and above.
Okay, and they're the ones that we're going to be looking at.
These are the ones,
this video,
the models that we've hit, And then you can see there, category 4, high handicap iron, 20 handicap and below. So the guys who are relatively new to the game as well. Mm-hmm. And then number 5 would be your ultimate forgiving, the hybrid iron.
Brilliant. Okay, so that's how we break each of the irons down. Let's move on and look at how the 14 different irons in the 3 and 3.5 categories compare. We have created all of this data inside using a GC Quad launch monitor and a Callaway ChromeSoft X golf ball. And we've used the ChromeSoft X, Neil, because you've hit it last year and you were really impressed with it. And you've been looking at making the switch to it as well.
Yeah, like I say, so I'm really impressed. Throughout the bag as well, wedge spin's been brilliant, mid-iron control, and it's been quick off the face for the driver as well. So yeah, it gets the thumbs up in all categories.
Okay, so just talk us through a little bit about how the irons compare. Shall we start off on the dispersion? Because everyone always goes, just show me where the shots go.
Good point, Simon. So dispersion, guys, can be misleading. Firstly, if I was to hit one 25 yards left and 25 yards right, give me an average of 0, mm-hmm. which, as we know, is a very accurate average. And another reason that we do it is how I'm striking it on one day could differ from how I'm striking on the next. So it can give misleading data.
Yeah, so we've definitely seen it in the past that Neil on one day might hit shots into a 5-yard dispersion circle, but then the following week or the following month with the same club won't be able to hit it into a 20-yard dispersion circle. You know, so it could be really, really misleading. What we look at instead is what you give up in terms of carry distance. So what's the drop-off between your longest and your shortest? That's what we've got here.
Yeah.
So just tell us a little bit about what you would take from this, Neil.
Yeah, so looking at the data, guys, the first thing you're going to pick up on is there's a little bit of an array in distance there from 185 right the way down to 161. But what you've got to remember is we're using different lofts. So stronger loft obviously equates to more ball speed, which equates to a little bit more distance. But one thing I do want to pick up on is I get quite a few comments saying, oh, guys are just, the manufacturers are just making stronger lofts, and they're making stronger lofts for a reason. But just take, for instance, this Callaway Maverick, guys, 27 degree loft on a 7-9, which we'd agree sounds strong, isn't it?
Extremely.
But it's getting to a fantastic peak height of 35, and the descent angle, of 47.6. Those numbers there are perfect. So it's getting to the correct peak height. It's coming in at the angle that's going to hold the green. They're strong lofted for a reason, how the construction and the design of them. So don't get carried away with that, guys, and worried that you're not going to get the correct peak height, really.
Worthwhile just pointing out as well that you probably need a reasonable amount of club speed to be able to get to that.
Yeah, definitely. But when you do, this is why it's important to get fitted for the product. If you can get to the correct peak height, and you can get the descent angle that you're looking for, and it's going the correct distance, I wouldn't worry too much about the lofts.
Great. Okay. And what we would say as well is that you might not agree with all of the selections that we make about our favourite irons of the year, but you can use this chart so you can make up your own mind. So just tell us, the PXG long and it had the smallest amount of drop off, which is pretty impressive.
Yeah, really impressed. To win both category guys, this PXG 0311XP, bit of a mouthful there, but yeah, fantastic iron. To win, like I say, the carry distance 185 yards with the 7-iron's good going, I'm happy with that. And to top the carry distance drop off, really good performer, good great construction.
And also that you might not sort of immediately notice, but the ping is down here. Mm. So it's not the longest iron in the world, but we love the idea that they've squeezed the long and left miss and the short right miss. And it's actually a drop off of
well
two
there, Simon,
at 4.6%, which is very, very small. So depending on what you're looking for, you know, for distance, for accuracy, there's a lot of different choices to be made here.
Yeah, there's a lot. I mean, all of those irons are good performance, but you can see there, looking at the data, there's a few that stand out.
Brilliant. Okay, so if we just move on, okay, just to look at the category comparison. So we've already mentioned about the category to 1 to 5.
Yeah.
Just explain a little bit, you know, about if I make the wrong choice, so if I choose an iron from this category, what I'm giving up compared to an iron in this category.
Yeah, it's huge, isn't it? And again, the thing that strikes me is your categories here, your 2.5, 3, 3.5, I'm still getting the optimum spin numbers, the optimum peak height, the optimum launch numbers, but look what I sacrifice in distance if I go to a category 2 over a category 3, category 4, just for the pure fact really of a little bit of a better looking club, because they tend to be a little bit better looking, don't they, in the lower number category, Simon. But to give up there, that's like 11 yards. That's huge.
And also to give up a further 10 yards against an iron which might be in the category 4 is absolutely huge as well. Okay, so are we going to move on and look at our best mid-handicap irons of 2021?
Let's do it.
Okay, so our best mid-handicap irons of 2021. We've picked out four top models. Oh, what are they, Neil? Let's have a quick look.
Yeah, our four standout performers, guys. So you've got the PXG 0311XP. We've got the Ping G425. You've got the Callaway-Apex-21DCB, deep cavity back. And then we've got the TaylorMade Sim 2 Max.
Okay, so just to explain a little bit about why we've chosen these top four models. You've obviously already seen that on the PXGs, they were the longest and they had the smallest amount of drop-off. But it's highly likely that you'll also want to try the PXG 0211s, because these are new, you know, sort of half the price of what the XPs are up here. So both are really, really nice irons. You get about 10% more MOI up here on the XP compared to the 0211. But you really need to weigh up the costs, because there is going to be a big difference. At the moment, these are £205 per club, whereas the 0211s are £119 a club. So there's a big difference in price. But you can't really make a bad choice. We've obviously plumped for this one because it was the longest and it had the smallest amount of carry distance drop off. Just tell us a bit more about the Ping G425, because it's just a good all-rounder.
Yeah, Ping, they, as we know, they've made a fantastic product forever, haven't they? But the G425, the tech in there of squeezing that long left miss to short right miss to get the drop-offs a little bit tighter. And we saw that in the data as well, didn't we? So that was very, very nice. And another thing is they do like the short iron, Simon, they're quite compact. Nobody likes to see a big chunky short iron, do they? They might in a long iron, because that's where you want your forgiveness. But for them to be progressive, like you say, in the short irons, that's a really nice touch as well.
Okay, so just a really, really good all-rounder. Okay, so moving on to the Apex 21 DCB. We could have gone either way. We could have gone with the standard Apex as well. But why do we go with the DCB?
I just think that for maximum forgiveness, really. It's still
it
with
just
the, with the four side. Yeah, and it gives it opens up to a wider audience, does it? A wider variety of ball strikers, shall we say.
Yeah.
So that's why we've popped that in there, guys.
And it really wasn't that long ago that you couldn't really buy a great forged iron aimed at mid-handicapper. We've loved Apex since the CF16s.
Yeah.
So a really, really good option. You know, down to you whether you want to go the standard route or the DCB route. You know, both are very, very strong
or
options.
Or again, the combination sets there, I suppose.
Okay, and we also like the Elevate shafts. So the way that you can get slightly heavier, you know, in the more players models, going up to the lighter models in this, you know, and the standard Apex. You know, it's a really, really nice offering.
Yeah, quite soft feeling as well, Sam, which is what I like.
It really gets the golf up there,
yeah.
Doesn't it?
Yeah, they've really got it boxed off there, Callaway, I feel. I'd say throughout the range, soft feeling in the dynamic gold shaft. What's a great idea to have your lighter shaft options and your heavier shaft options, definitely.
Okay, and then to move on to the TaylorMade Sim 2 Max.
I'm a fan. The big thing for me is that they feel very powerful off the face, especially. I'm a fan of the long irons in them. Do you know what I mean? If you're somebody that's looking for maximum ball speed, things like that, then it's a great option. Again, from a compact looking head as well.
Yeah. And it's probably worth just pointing out as well, it's not the strongest loft in the category.
No.
You know, if you really want to chase distance, then you need to be looking at the OS model.
Yeah, definitely. And again, the TaylorMade there, a little bit like the other brands that we've mentioned, they've got options there for every golfer, haven't they? Like I say, if you're looking for a little bit more distance, look at that stronger lofted option in the OS.
Okay, so that is our best mid-handicap irons of 2021. If you've got any comments or questions, leave them below, and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.